This show contains strong language and opinions. Left, right, and center snowflakes be advised. One angry New York City Puerto Rican decided to start a podcast, determined to piss the world off. By shoving a mirror in front of society's face, he puts them on the defensive. This is On the Offensive with Louis B.
Yo, what's up? This is On the Offensive with Louis B, where we kick the issues in the balls. We're on an active war against bullshit. We would do anything and everything to expose bullshit. The ends sometimes justify the means. So if you're angry and want the truth exposed, then strap in and prepare to be shocked. This is Smash Mouth Talk. If you can't accept that, then fuck off. I'm your host, Louis B. I takes no bullshit from nobody. I actually expose the bullshit in society and chop it up into easy to digest chunks for you today. Today, I am just going to be discussing today's topic is politics has become a fucking cult. It is nothing but another man-made fucking religion. And honestly, I got this by watching both Kamala Harris and Donald Trump's speeches. I am so sick and tired of the fucking sloganeering. And honestly, the more I watch it, the more I realize the subliminal messages. It was just subliminal, like almost like a hypnotic cadence to both of their speeches. Trump is easier to spot. It's like up and down, up and down. It's like a flow. He had his flow. And how people worship other humans. Like, I was about to originally talk about how Kamala is horrible and how she shouldn't be voted for. And honestly, at this point, as someone that, yeah, I went to the Capitol. I didn't go there to do what the fuck happened because it was the whole cult, of personality that took over some people, and they just went fucking buck wild, and that was able to be taken advantage of and used, and then they were able to twist it and put people in prison for decades for not even doing anything. But the fact is, it's like, whether you're left, right, or center, it's become a fucking religion. Like, especially on the left, if you're a fucking atheist, yet you're worshiping a human person because, oh my God, he believes in trans issues, or she believes in trans issues, or she's a woman, or she's a woman of color. Oh my God, I'm going to worship you. I'm going to kiss your ass because you're a person of color. You have more melanin than I do, so you must know better. No. Or, oh my God.
Oh, yeah, you say the things that you hate the things I hate. Oh my God. I'm going to kiss your ass.
Like, and this is coming from someone that was guilty of this. And I'm just fucking now realizing. I'm like, not just now realizing, but I'm realizing it. Like, it's a fucking sickness. And honestly, I keep harping on this. Nothing fucking changes. Nothing fucking gets better. Things just get worse and worse and worse. You think they're gonna stop? You think they're gonna stop inflation? No, because no one can really stop inflation because the economy is a living, breathing thing. If you read the Austrian Book of Economics, I'm saying it wrong. It's late. I can't even think of the Austrian School of Economics. There you go. It's a living, breathing thing. And the more the government fucks with anything, the worse it gets. I mean, would it be better if we, like, look, there's some ideas that Trump says that I like. Like, okay, don't tax the fuck out of people. Yes. But how the fuck are we going to pay our debts? We need to pay our debts. Which means, hey, how's about we drill and we sell our energy to countries that, you know, don't want to rely on Russia or China or Brazil. And we take payment in gold. How's that? That sounds, and then hey, we pay off our debts. And then we tell China to go fuck themselves, and we stop dealing with China, and we start building our own shit, and we sell and we build our shit properly. So that way, when it says made in America, it means qualita and actually made in America. I don't know. But this is something that's not going to take 4 or 8 years to fucking fix. It's going to take decades, and we're gonna have to eat shit for a little bit. We're gonna have to like sacrifice so that way our kids can fucking actually, you know, be able to live like kings. I mean, that's gonna take a lot of personal sacrifice, but hey, Americans are not into that, which is why China is kicking our ass, because they were able to like, what, 50 years of eating shit. I mean, and they're still eating shit, but look, Google Chinese street fashion, and you got these fucking, you know, you got these Chinese people on the street, walking in the street, dressed like fucking supermodels. Whether that shit is fake or not, I don't know. I mean, the fact that they fake a lot of their shit. I mean, that's another thing. Hey, how's about we crack down on all these illegal immigrants that are selling knockoff shit? I've seen it. I've made fun of them for doing it. You know what I like to do? They usually do it at Canal Street or Fifth Avenue in Manhattan. Like, they'll have like a little like tarp laid out, and they'll have like fake bags and shit. What I like to do is I like to act like I'm running. Well, no, I'm running, and I act like, oh my God, the cops are coming. The cops are coming. So that way they have to like pack up real quick, knowing full well there's no fucking cop behind me. So basically just wasting their time and making them have to like set up somewhere else. Probably just like making sure they can't really make a dishonest buck. Because at the end of the day, they're supporting terrorism. That's where that, a lot of that money goes. So thinking you're getting a deal by buying something fake, even though you could tell that it's fake. I know, because my god sister, I take pictures and I send it to him. I'm like, hey, look, I'm doing Christmas shopping. And like, you better fucking not. You better fucking not, you dick. I'll fuck you. She's like, I will kill you. I will hunt you down and kill you if you buy me a fake purse. And like, honestly, I try to talk them down. They're like, oh, $500. Like, $500 for a fake fucking bag? Get the fuck out of here. I'll give you 20 bucks. And they look at me like, suck my dick. No, you suck my dick for $500? $500 for a fake bag? It better come with a fucking freshly trafficked. No, I'm kidding. Let me not finish that before someone's like, so you came to meet up with a fucking freshly sex trafficked migrant, and then I get fucked up by Vitaly or whoever, or Bradley Martin, they'll come with to just kick my ass. Just jokes. People know. The woman of my dreams is Christina Scabbia of Lacuna Coil. Like my women, smart, talented, and dark. Yeah, goth and nerdy. Oh, yeah. A goth nerdy chick. Oh, my God. Yeah. Okay, that's the official tangent. So, anyways, if you're a goth nerdy, If you're a goth nerdy chick between the ages of 35 and 41, hit up my line. That was shameless. But yeah, just back to this whole, it was like no one is fixing this shit. I keep saying this over and over on almost every podcast that I have done since starting this show. All they do is blame each other. Like, each party blames each party for the problems instead of actually fixing the fucking problems. And then when one side tries to actually fix the problems, the other side blocks it because they don't want the other side to get credit for fixing the problem. Then why don't you fix the fucking, why don't you get in on it, fix the problem together, so that way you could be like, see, well, I helped fix the problem. It was bipartisan, blah, 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 whatever the fuck. And then, you know, after, and here's another thing that it just came to mind. Because I was watching, you know, watching videos on YouTube, and, you know, Kamala Harris fucking commercial happens. Because, first of all, Google, YouTube, can you cut the shit with so many motherfucking commercials? So many motherfucking commercials on your fucking videos. Like, I was watching this one video, and it starts off with a commercial, and then plays like 2 minutes of a fucking, 1 hour video. And within 2 minutes in, it's another double commercial that you can't even fucking skip. Like, are you motherfuckers that hard up? Like, I'm all for fucking capitalism and shit. I love capitalism. But when does it become fucking predatory? Once it becomes predatory, I'm like, yo, come on. Now, that's just dishonest. It's wrong. That's just bad faith, my friend. Okay, but back to what I was saying. I was watching a video, and the commercial was, of course, Kamala Harris saying, Donald Trump is an existential threat to democracy, which is the fucking rhetoric that will get some fucking lunatic to think, okay, I need to take a pop shot at him. Like, what the fuck, bitch? Why the fuck are you saying shit? Like, because money bet, if Donald Trump said, well, Kamala Harris is an existential threat to democracy, she's dangerous, she's horrible, they'll be like, what, you trying to fucking paint a target on the back? If Donald Trump said that same exact shit, he would be fucking crucified. And that's another thing I can't stand about the fucking media. Like, okay, if you're gonna dunk on the president, yeah, okay, dunk on the president, yeah, get him on the proper shit to dunk on him. If you're gonna dunk on Kamala Harris, dunk on her for the right things. If you're gonna dunk on Biden, dunk on him on the shit that he does wrong. Yes, of course, that's fair game. When it comes to Donald Trump, dunk on him on the stupid shit and the wrong shit that he's done and said. That's fair game. But the problem I have is when it comes to Trump, the selective editing and putting words in his mouth. They're like, oh, when he said the, he meant he hates blacks. Like, what the fuck? Every time he's pandering. Oh no, he's pandering. He's pandering to the black vote. Oh, okay. And Kamala isn't? Really, Miss Woman that has fucking thrown black people in jail and kept innocent black people in jail by withholding evidence that, you know, like this is shit that you could look up. Like, can we just keep it a buck, man? On both of them. Keep it a buck on both of them. Yeah, I fuck prostitutes. Like, honestly, Trump, I would respect Trump. He's like, yeah, I fuck prostitutes. Yeah, I fuck Stormy Daniels. No, I didn't use campaign money to fucking do it. The fuck? But you know who really kills it? Is the fucking Christian evangelicals. that fucking canonized Trump. Like, motherfuckers, no, he is not. Obviously, not ordained by God. He's not the second coming of Christ. Like, come on, bro. The guy that fucks hookers, the guy that cheats on his wives, the guy that has multiple wives that divorced them because he cheated. Yeah, no, that's not the guy God wants. And I'm pretty sure Trump hasn't even, repented for all the wrong he's done, all the immoral shit he's done. So please, Christian evangelicals that are like, that were like freaking singing hymns and songs and whatnot on January. That shit was just redonkulous. Like the fucking, like the religious zealots, bro. Like, okay, be religious, but fucking be realistic, bro. Like, I don't know what you're seeing, but just because he says that he's against the things that you hate, like, honestly, you could be against trans kids being allowed to transition, children, underage children being freaking attacked and basically groomed, and not be religious about it. Not be like, God has ordained them to stop the gays. Like, no, stop. Like, come on, God, welcome to, like, join us in the real world, please. That's what also makes this all cult like. Like, we could be real. Like, okay, look, has Trump done some questionable shit when it comes to his business? Yeah, no shit. Of course he has. Everyone knows that he's been bankrupt and he's, you know, he doesn't pay his bills. Yeah, no shit. No shit. But, you know, he does say some good shit. He does say some good shit that the other candidates are not, or other candidate at this point are not saying. I mean, I don't know. I haven't heard Kamala talk about what she's going to do with illegal immigration. I don't know what she's going to, like, honestly, because a lot of these people can't stay. They can't stay here. They can't. We can't help them all. It's too much too fast. We cannot help them all. They have to go back. And we have to force Venezuela to take them back. This is like, oh no, we're not taking them back. No, fuck that. You're taking them back. Even if we got to fucking airdrop them. And then you just deal with it, whatever. Like, if we got to do a military action where it's like, okay, we dare you to fucking fire on us. Like, I swear, like, we'll fuck you up. We'll fuck you up. You're taking back your citizens. Madero, you're going to be deposed. I mean, but honestly, then that'll end up being we'll end up having like a puppet government and we don't want that shit. Hell, how's about we get like a fucking Bukele, a Venezuelan Bukele. That would be fucking fantastic. Yeah, the Venezuelan Bukele. That would be good for his people. They got the oil. So, oh my God, that would be great. Oh my God. Just think about it. Have Argentina, a libertarian Argentina. You got Bukele. I keep forgetting what fucking country he runs. Yeah, Salvador. San Salvador. Yeah. Salvador, yeah, that's the brother is 43, and see, that's another issue. How old is Kamala Harris? I mean, I swear to God, if she's close to our age, my age, and she fucking acting like that, she's 59. Nah, okay. I don't know. We need somebody our age. We need someone our age. Like, seriously, I don't know. Someone our age that just like, okay, we're gonna,
whatever fucking decisions I make are going to affect me. So let me try to, like, honestly, because let's just face it. All politicians, no matter the party, are fucking selfish as fuck. Let's just be real. Like, I really want someone that is probably my age, that will be affected by the decisions he or she makes, and that are not gonna take shit from any world, any other government, other countries, not listen to the UN, United Abominations, as it were. As the song goes by a Megadeth, the UN is right. They can be any more us. They are right now. The UN is a dud. Another mushroom cloud. So, United Abominations. Like, I just... It just...
Today, not tomorrow, oh, not here next it is. Week. Today is the day I hope you will donate to support our movement.
No.
Because the
bowel movement.
Time is running out. We're in the final lap of this race. Mm-hmm. Election day will be yep. here before you and I know it. So I need you to act now so your donation can have the greatest impact.
No.
The stakes in this election could not be higher, and we cannot throw up our hands when we must roll.
Yeah, and another one, she's like, he is the biggest threat to democracy. You say shit like that, it's gonna try somebody, some of the nutcases gonna be like, well, I gotta take another shot at him. The fuck? Yeah, no one says nothing. No one says anything. Honestly, like, being on the other side, like, dealing with all the political violence, dealing with people encouraging people to, like, don't talk to your family so that way they learn not to support Trump. Distance yourself. Like, the fuck? Yeah, if it was the other way around, where it's like, okay, don't talk to anyone that's into Biden. Don't talk to anyone on the left. Just disregard them. Like, it's like they're the ones that started this shit. But when like the lot of, like, this is the other thing I hate, man. Besides the whole cult of person, the whole cult surrounding these two candidates, or these two parties. Like, I just hate the worship. I hate the fucking worship. This is just like, it's just fucking upsetting. It's disgusting. I mean. God, I wish I could be funny right now. It's just the frustration. And I mean, the only thing I can think of is, like, we need to start looking for someone. We need to start looking for someone that both sides could be like, yeah, fine. We need to get rid of all the extremism from both sides. Because honestly, like, both sides have gotten too far, bro. Either you're too ultra, like, they ultra religious, especially with the America 25. What is it called? Is that was it called the America 25? Like, you want to turn this country into fucking wives, Handmaid's Tale? The fuck? A religious, you want to turn this into a fucking a Christian religious state? Yeah, we're worrying about Sharia, huh? We're worried about the Sharia. And then the other side, you want to go so far where people are not having enough kids, so the kids that are around, you want to encourage them to chop off their genitals and really just fuck up their chances of furthering the species. Or just making it so that way we let's normalize pedophilia. I mean, I'm so glad there are people out there that are fucking knocking these motherfuckers out, making it so that way it's not safe for them anymore on the streets. Because God forbid they get arrested and they get a slap on the fucking wrist. Oh, slap on the motherfucking wrist. Like, how the fuck are you doing less time raping a child than you would if I killed someone defending myself? Ain't that some shit? Like, if somebody were to attack me and I kill them in the process of defending myself, I could face more time than if somebody else, I'm not even going to put myself in this scenario, if somebody else raped a child. And I'm just, and I'm making sure I'm putting the scenario. If I kill someone while in self-defense, in the process of self-defense, and then somebody else rapes a child, I could be facing more time. Like those three boys, they like to call them men, those three Latino boys that killed their stepfather, that killed the stepfather. One of them was a friend who's a brother. That's not a friend, that's a brother. The three guys that killed their stepfather because the stepfather touched their sister. Brothers Christian and Alejandro Trevino and their friend Juan Melendez are charged in the death of Gabriel Quintanilla. Christian and Juan are both charged with capital murder, while Alejandro is charged with aggravated assault with a deadly weapon. Mm-hmm. The father, who was on the run from police from raping another child, like so basically, Juan and Christian are facing life without the possibility of parole. They beat that man to death. Like, you touch, like, honestly, and tell me, what brother would not do the same thing? If I found out one of my nieces or nephews, well, you know, not real nieces and nephews, but if I found out they were touched, whoever did it better be fucking running for the fucking hills. They better run and hide somewhere where I can't find them, because I'll be laughing in jail. I'd be like, yeah. I bounced his head off the fucking pavement and I slit his throat. And, you know, he made the lovely sound as the blood was gurgling out. You know? Yeah. Good times. You know? It's like, no. It was like, I sacrificed him. I sacrificed him to God. He touched my niece or nephew, and then he basically said, "Louis, can you send me the God?" And I said, "Well, why not? I got nothing to do. I got all day. I got time today. Surprise, motherfucker! Goodbye." No, laughing in jail, laughing my ass in court. Like, yeah, you know, yeah, and I hope he's burning in hell. And yet you want to arrest these three teenage boys. They call them men, but they're boys. Okay, well, you know what? At this point, they're men now. They're men now, because that's man shit. That is man shit. That is your default setting to protect your family. Hold on. Let me get this here. Oops. Let me get this here.
Cases coming out of Texas. Two brothers accused in the deadly beating of their stepfather were in court today for a status hearing. The alleged motive for the killing was the victim was suspected of molesting the suspect's half-sister. Brothers Christian and Alejandro Trevino and...
Okay, first of all, like I said before, he was already wanted for the police from raping somebody, raping another child. Suspected. He's dead. No. No, if any child came up to me by like, "Louis, this person touched me," no fucking questions asked. No questions. He touched me in my no-no spot. Wait, what he do? First, taking her to the police. I'm calling the police. Police comes, take her to the hospital. Then I do work. Then Uncle Louis does work. Back to this here.
and their friend Juan Melendez are charged in the death of Gabriel Quintanilla. Now, Christian and Juan are both charged with capital murder, while Alejandro was charged with aggravated assault with a deadly weapon. Now, Christian is the first of the three scheduled to stand trial, but today his trial was pushed from next week to May 20th of next year. Quintanilla was found beaten to death in McAllen, Texas in 2022. Days later, police announced they had arrested the three suspects after his body was discovered. The police chief revealed that the beating began with allegations of sexual assault involving the defendant and the suspect's 9-year-old half-sister. We are covering the beginning.
Why the fuck did they push it to 2024? Yo, I swear, honestly, I hope there's jury nullification when it comes to this. And honestly, that's what should happen. It should be up to jury nullification and be like, innocent. Oh no. Oh yeah. No. We don't give a fuck about the evidence. Oh wait, did the guy actually rape the kid? Oh. Innocent. I vote innocent. No matter what, innocent. Jury nullification. It should be well known. You kill a pedophile, no jury will convict you. A child rapist? Oh my God, no jury will convict you. Thank you for your service. In fact, here's $200. Like, I'm looking at their freaking, their mugshots. These kids are like, they got their heads up high. They're like, yeah, nah, fuck that shit. They're not even fucking crying. They're like, that's some stone-faced motherfuckers right there. 2025, May 20th, 2025. The fuck? So they gotta sit in jail for that long. Like, unfucking believable, bro. Unfucking believable. But yeah, back to this topic of it's a cult. Politics has become a fucking cult. And the only way to do it is to just, like, look, either don't vote and just be the change. You make the changes yourself. Because at this point, it's like, fuck this. I could do it by myself. Fuck this. And you know what? You know how I'm combating it? Okay? I don't like all these illegals here. Okay, fine. I'm not giving them my money. I haven't gotten takeout in years. If I want takeout, I go and pick it up my damn self. I don't have shit delivered to me, unless it's Amazon. But food deliveries, nope, no more. No DoorDash, no Grubhub. The other ones. None of that. I go pick that shit up myself. Ugh, unfucking believable, bro. Anyways, like to thank you for downloading and listening. Please tell your friends and family on how to listen to the show. And leave a comment. Leave a comment. Subscribe. Send me a message. Follow me on Instagram at LouieBComedy1. That's LOUIEBEE comedy numero uno. And as always, from my house to your house, mahalo.
That's the end of my show. Donk.